brothers and sisters. I want to welcome you back to life. Back to the one that can make your next chapter your best chapter. Hallelujah.
How can it be that you love the most unlovable part of me? Of me. How could you see your life was the only gift I'll ever need to be free? It's amazing with you. I win even if I lose. Everything's working for my good for always.
Come on.
He saved the day. Woo. He will come through. He won't know that's not what superheroes do.
Hallelujah.
No.
You
cover me.
I appreciate it.
A mystery.
It's amazing how
your patience with me, God will never leave.
You don't give up on me.
Don't ever leave.
Help me.
Help me to see like you.
Like you.
No matter what I go through,
hey.
Everything's working for my good for a way.
Let me tell you what he does.
He saves the day.
And he will.
He will come through.
Hallelujah. Not real superheroes.
No greater love.
A love like this
makes my heart beat.
And I promise you,
all I wanna do is make you proud of me.
That's why
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
You.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
Yes.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
I searched all over.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
You.
I don't wanna love nobody but you.
That's right.
I don't wanna love nobody. Love nobody but you.
And the church saying, come on.
Loving you will be.
Jesus loving you
will be the death of me.
It sounds crazy, don't it? Hey.
That's how it's supposed to be.
Let me tell you what it means.
More of you, less of me.
That's why.
I don't want to love nobody but you. I don't want to love nobody but you.
Father.
I don't want to love nobody. Love nobody but you.
I really mean it this time.
I don't want to love nobody but you.
Jesus.
I don't want to love nobody but you. I don't want to love nobody. Love nobody but you.
Good evening. Tonight we are excited to present the Howard University Homecoming Gospel Concert. With so much going on in our world, we are indeed blessed to gather with the Howard University community to celebrate in song what anchors us. Our resilient faith.
We shall overcome. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Someday, deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome someday. God is on our side. God is on our side. God is on our side today. Deep in my heart. I do believe
Lift every voice and sing, till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea.
Yeah. We, the African-American people of this nation, in order to form a more perfect union, must pursue our inalienable rights.
To not be defined by racism.
To not have disparity be our new normal.
To not be judged by the color of our skin,
or the texture of our hair,
or the pronunciation of our names.
To not walk down the street and see clutched purses,
or fixed gazes,
or to be followed around in stores.
To not be told,
go back where you came from.
To not live in buildings built by bigotry.
To not be called the worst word in the English language.
To not be on the heavy sides of the scales of justice.
To not live in fear of becoming the next Breonna Taylor,
George Floyd,
a Tatiana Jefferson,
Elijah McClain,
Pamela Turner,
and Ahmaud Arbery.
To not be told.
To not be told to shut up and dribble.
We.
And we, the African American citizens of each state, shall be entitled
to be served and protected, not profiled and targeted.
To have our education valued more than our incarceration.
To have daughters and sons who will live long enough
to become women and men.
To have our history taught as American history.
To become the American dream instead of the American nightmare.
To live the truths of who we are.
Not the lies of what you believe.
To have the country we pledge allegiance to.
Pledge allegiance to us.
To have the Constitution we give our lives to defend.
Defend our lives.
To have the anthem we're told to stand for.
Stand for us.
To live like our lives matter.
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 To live like our lives matter just as much as yours.
To live like our lives matter just as much as yours.
Just as much as yours.
Just as much as yours.
To live like our lives matter just as much as yours.
To live like our lives matter just as much as yours.
Better than good to me.
better than good to me. You've been better than good to me. Oh, you've been better than good to me. God, you've been better than good to me. You've been better than good to me.
no other name in heaven or in earth where men can be saved, yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Strong tower for all who call on it. Oh, yeah, yeah. His safety in his name. So tell me, who can stand before us when we call on that great name? Everybody say,
Jesus.
Hey, we know there's no name, no name higher than Jesus. We call on you, Savior, the same Jesus. And we say, there's no name higher, there's no name higher than there's safety, safety in his name. So tell me, who can stand before us when we call on his glorious name? Everybody shout it. Hey, we know there's no name higher, there's no name higher than. Every tongue confess, I came and who have to flee. Yes, Lord, at the name of our God, at the name of Jesus, every knee will bow, and every tongue confess, oh, demons have to flee. Oh, at the name of our God, at the name of Jesus, every tongue will confess, demons have to flee. Oh, yeah. Declare, say, have the name of, have the name of Jesus, the highest name in heaven or earth. All will confess and bow before him. Sing, have the name of.
Jesus together. In John 6 and 63, Jesus says, the words I have spoken to you are spirit and life. And so we're going to declare the word of our God. We're going to write his word on our hearts and declare it over our families, over our city. Come on, let's declare it. We're going to write straight. We're going to take the words and the truth of our God, and we're going to write it on the tablet of our heart. Come on. Them on the tablet of your heart. Song says this: I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me will forever be fruitful indeed. Yeah. It's Lord. I am the way, the truth, and the light. No one gets to the Father except that they come through me. So let my mercy and truth sing of forsake. Let not mercy and truth sing of forsake. Set your really on. Truth and the light, say.
Truth and the light.
No one gets to the Father.
When people see my praise, they ask me why, and I respond with this reply. He's done marvelous things for me.
I am voting because it is my right.
I vote.
I am voting
because it's my responsibility.
It's my responsibility.
Because it is.
Is my duty.
My right.
Because my voice matters.
Hi, everyone. I just wanted to take a moment to say thank you for all that you're doing to help everyone in this country make their voices heard in this year's election and in every election. Your work has never been more important. From the ongoing pandemic to the passion and protests we've seen for racial and social justice, it's clear that we're in the middle of a big moment in this country. And that means we need leadership that honestly reflects who we are and what we stand for. Our job between now and November is to make sure everyone we know understands that the power to make change rests on our ability to cast a vote. Fair and safe voting is going to be more important than ever this year. And that's why When We All Vote is fighting to expand vote by mail, in-person early voting, and online voter registration. Now, I'm going to be honest. We're really gonna need your help to make these efforts a success. Luckily, the first step is an easy one. Just spread the word. Make sure your friends, families, and communities are registered, know their rights, and are fully prepared to vote by mail this year or vote early in person. So, Go to whenweallvote.org to find out more and get yourselves, your families, and your friends ready to make their voices heard. Let's get more folks across the country trained with the tools, the resources, and the information they'll need to vote, because this election couldn't be more important.
Sometimes you need to feel the pain and sting of defeat to activate the real passion and purpose that God predestined inside of you. God says in Jeremiah, I know the plans I have for you. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Graduating class, hear me well on this day. When you have reached the hilltop and you are deciding on next jobs, next steps, careers, further education, you would rather find purpose than a job or a career. Purpose crosses disciplines. Purpose is an essential element of you. It is the reason you are on the planet at this particular time in history. Your very existence is wrapped up in the things you are here to fulfill. Whatever you choose for a career path, remember the struggles along the way are only meant to shape you for your purpose. When I dare to challenge the system that would relegate us to victims and stereotypes with no clear historical backgrounds, no hopes or talents, when I question that method of portrayal, a different path opened up for me. The path to my destiny. When God has something for you, it doesn't matter who stands against it. God will move someone that's holding you back away from a door and put someone there who will open it for you. If it's meant for you, I don't know what your future is, but if you are willing to take the harder way, the more complicated one, the one with more failures at first than successes, the one that has ultimately proven to have more meaning, more victory, more glory, then you will not regret it. Now, this is your time. The light of new realization shines on you today. Howard's legacy is not wrapped up in the money that you will make, but the challenges that you choose to confront. As you commence to your past, press on with pride and press on with purpose. God bless you. I love you, Howard. Howard forever.
Troubled times, seems like Let this affirmation be our ringing cry. It will give us the courage to face the uncertainties of the future. It will give our tired feet new strength as we continue our forward stride toward the city of freedom. When our days become dreary with low hovering clouds of despair, when our nights become darker than a thousand midnights, let us remember that there is a creative force in this universe working to pull down the gigantic mountains of evil, a power that is able to make a way out of no way and transform dark yesterdays into bright tomorrows. Let us realize that the arc of the moral universe is long, but it bends toward justice.
First chapter of the book of James reminds us of God's faithfulness. It says that every good and perfect gift comes from above, from the Father who created the heavens and the earth, who doesn't change. So whenever I'm in doubt, I remember that the Lord is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Great is I want you to think of God's faithfulness. I want you to be reminded that He promised He would never leave you, He would never forsake you, and He hasn't done it yet. Lord, unto me. Great is. Promise that you would see about us. Lord, unto me.
Lord, unto me.
Come on, stand and sing with us.